The fact that The Lion King is probably the first film that speaks of Africa, Africans, and our culture in a way that is so positive, that when the movie came out 25 years ago, and I feel that strongly now, having seen this movie that we're doing,
absolutely,
it is not the norm that Hollywood used to have. The impact of the music starts with the very first 2.5 minutes of the opening of the movie, which I did as a demo. The music became the inspiration for how the rest of the soundtrack was going to be developed, and therefore complemented the script and the storyline.
Look, as a grandfather, when it was released in 1994, the animation version, it became the most exciting thing to watch young children watch. The story, like a cartoon, and you just watch over their shoulders and say, they like this. And then I went to New York and I saw the Lion King Lebu's work on Broadway. It was magic. The play was magic. The DNA, the aesthetics were Africa. And then you step back and you say, by the way, it is an African story.
Lebo M. That voice you hear at the beginning of the movie, he and I, we had worked on many movies, and we're gonna take this to Africa, and I'm not going to pretend to write African music, I'm just going to write this music that's in me, and I'm going to just throw it up, down in front of these choirs in Africa, and I'm just gonna go and see what happens when these two cultures collide.
It's kind of beautiful and serendipitous that Lion King the first time came out the way it did, because it was kind of like a commercial reminder to the world, Africa is a force.
Uma das coisas que pegam quem gosta de Rei Leão, acho que é a trilha sonora mesmo. Então, por exemplo, na música contemporânea eu já ouvi música de funk que tem sample do Rei Leão e por aí vai, assim, porque é coisas, é uma trilha que marcou as pessoas.
Afrobeats has obviously been popping off in like the continents of Africa, like Afropop songs. I love that, you know, people are getting in tune with the culture, are getting up, they're dancing, they're spinning the music.
You know, myself, I fell in love with the Lion King musical soundtrack back when it was on CD, to the point where I couldn't play it anymore, skip past each song. It just touches you.
Scores like The Lion King are they pave the future to what my child will listen to. And that, for me, if you start influencing the next generation, it's not just nice music that's gonna trend on radio, it lives way longer.
My hope and dream is that the young creative people, that is, if you are under 20 and under 35, you realize the value of authenticity and being an African artist. The significant value in producing quality material, the significant value in respecting your work as an African, inspired by who you are, our stories and our history.